Question number 12, Marama Davidson.
Tēnā koe, Mr. Speaker.
Tēnā koe.
Huri noi te whare, tēnā koutou. My question is to the Minister for Climate Change Issues. When she said this week at the Pacific Climate Change Conference that, quote, Pacific voices are heard loud and clear at the negotiating table, and there are some things that we hold different views on, end quote, what were the specific points of difference that she was referring to?
Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable
Speaker, there is a lot of common ground in the priorities that New Zealand and other Pacific countries have on climate change. I wasn't referring to anything specific when I made the comment. The sentiment I wanted to reflect was that climate change will obviously have a significant impact and is having a significant impact on Pacific nations, and we recognise that. But we may, for example, hold a different view currently on climate-induced migration and the timing of when something like that might happen. The point I was endeavouring to make in the speech is that we may have a lot of things in common, but New Zealand at no time should presume to speak for our Pacific neighbours.
Supplementary.
Supplementary question, Marama Davidson.
Does she agree with the Pacific's united call for a moratorium on new coal mines?
The Honourable Paula Bennett.
Mr. Speaker, no, not at this time.
Supplementary.
Supplementary question, Marama Davidson.
Will she support new ways for Pacific people to migrate to New Zealand in response to the President of Kiribati, Anote Tong's call for his people to be able to migrate with dignity?
We have agreements with Pacific countries. I think that we will continue to see issues in the area. It's something that we are keen over time to progress, but at this stage we stick with our current policies.
Supplementary question, Marama Davidson.
Isn't the major point of difference between this government and Pacific leaders that the Pacific nations are struggling and fighting to stay above water, and our climate target does not do nearly enough to help them in that fight?
Mr. Speaker, the reality is that actually New Zealand is doing a lot to help our Pacific countries. Right. We recently just announced more money, like $635 million, that we want to put in, and I see a lot of that, but that $200 million as well, being spent in those Pacific countries. There are things that we can do and are doing now, such as more renewable energy there that we're leading, a lot of that work that the Minister of Foreign Affairs is actually leading throughout Pacific countries. But there is, without it, I don't think our emissions target is actually what is causing the problems in the Pacific nations, but we will play more than our fair share in that area, and we will help our cousins as we should do.
And that concludes questions for oral answer.